It's not the schedule. It's the fact that Dave cannot suddenly change his own production schedule without major problems, that's all. Now, on the other hand, if you realize that the customer will work very hard to stick to his original building plan, by only building 50 per week, all you carry is 10 extra breakers on week number 3. But your turns are 20% higher than what you'd have if you keep the extra 10 breakers throughout the month.
But what if he asks suddenly for 70 breakers?
Why would he? If he can't build 50 widgets a week, it's unlikely that he's going to start building 70 all of a sudden. Unless he's only built 30 at some point, and then you know it and you've got the parts. In any case, you can run an analysis of the usual variation in your customer's demand against the average demand and build up a buffer stock accordingly.
But what if his production program increases?
Then it's totally another matter, and you need to address that differently. Remember that you need to find out what he intends to build in advance, rather than wait for the orders to fall.
And what if we have our own problems, like a breaker failing to pass testing or something?
Again, that's another problem. If you need safety stock to cover your own problems, well, create some. If, on average, you screw up assembly of one breaker in 100, then it means every other week when you thought you had produced 50, then you only have 49 shippable breakers. In this case, you still need to assume you're going to ship 50. So, keep a safety stock level of one extra breaker and plan to produce 51 breakers every second week, rather than 50. Fine, in total, and if nothing goes wrong at production, you end up at month end with an inventory of 2 extra breakers. It's still a lot less than 10.
So, we average the customer demand over 4 weeks, add a buffer to be sure we won't disappoint the customer, and then use that to schedule production?
Take care to maintain a finished goods inventory made up of average demand, a demand variation buffer to protect you from spikes in customer demand, and a safety stock to protect your customer from failures in your process. And you can then level it further by dividing your week by 5 production days. So 50 a week gives you 10 per day. And then break down the day to tack time, which is building a breaker every 46 minutes and so on. Got that?
Sounds clear. I don't know if we can do it, but I think I understand.
Good. Any more questions?
Not on this point as yet, Bob. But I've got a separate concern. Can you stay on the phone a minute after I wrap up the meeting?
Shoot.
Hang on. There, they're gone. To be honest, I'm getting a bit overwhelmed here. We're starting actions all over the plant. Now I'm getting into logistics as well. Amy is overworked, and I'm losing my bearings.
My father swung slowly in his chair but didn't say anything. We stared at the phone's speaker as Phil searched for words.
I know what you say about Gemba, but I need some way to keep a broader picture, to know where I'm going with this. I also realize that the information flow is just as important as the fabrication process, but it's all mixing up in my mind. I know that it sounds like a very general question, but do you know of anything that would help?
Maybe I do, Philip. Maybe I do. Tell you what. I'm going fishing again on Saturday, so if you want to meet me at the yacht club early on, we can discuss your problem.
Oh, that would be great. Thank you.
And bring Amy along. You'll need somebody with brains there.
Will do.